As a psychiatrist, I remember very well the condemnation by the American Psychiatric Association of Soviet psychiatrists and the Soviet Union for their use of psychiatric techniques and psychiatric medications to control political dissidents. Sadly, shockingly, we in the United States have become those same oppressors. We now have a policy, as exemplified by the FBI brochure from the Phoenix Office on Counterterrorism, which says people who are defenders of the U.S. Constitution against federal government and the UN and make numerous references to the U.S. Constitution should be monitored as potentially murderous, and fanatical terrorists, by extension, should be considered mentally unstable. Under the New Freedom Commission, mentally unstable people must be medicated on a compulsory basis with lethal and untested but very profitable psychiatric medications.
Think about it. This is the first time in the history of the United States a sitting president has sided with a foreign government to sue the citizens of its country. For defending our laws, for defending and protecting the citizens of the state of Arizona, it's outrageous and it's impeachable. You think it couldn't get any worse. But then she's going to drag us again before the UN, the Human Rights Commission. We're going to be judged on human rights by Uganda, Cuba, Libya, Hugo Chavez. Wow.
Mr. Co-President Nigel Farage, Freedom and Democracy.
Well, good morning, Mr. Van Rompuy. You've been in office for 1 year. And in that time, the whole edifice is beginning to crumble. There's chaos. The money's running out. I should thank you. You should perhaps be the pin-up boy of the Eurosceptic movement. But just look around this chamber this morning. Just look at these faces. Look at the fear. Look at the anger. Poor old Barroso here looks like he's seen a ghost. You know, they're beginning to understand that the game is up. And yet, in their desperation to preserve their dream, they want to remove any remaining traces of democracy from the system. And it's pretty clear that none of you have learned anything. You know, when you yourself, Mr. Van Rompuy, say that the euro has brought us stability, I suppose I could applaud you for having a sense of humour, but isn't this really just the bunker mentality? You know, your fanaticism is out in the open. You talked about the fact that it was a lie to believe that the nation state could exist in a 21st century globalized world. Well, that may be true in the case of Belgium, who haven't had a government for 6 months, but for the rest of us, right across every member state in this union, and perhaps this is why we see the fear in the faces, increasingly people are saying, we don't want that flag, we don't want the anthem, we don't want this political class, we want the whole thing consigned to the dustbin of history. And we had the Greek tragedy earlier on this year, and now we have the situation in Ireland. Now I know that the stupidity and greed of Irish politicians has a lot to do with this. They should never ever have joined the euro. They suffered with low interest rates, a false boom and a massive bust. But look at your response to them. What they're being told as their government's collapsing is that it would be inappropriate for them to have a general election. In fact, Commissioner Wren here said they had to agree their budget first before they'd be allowed to have a general election. Just who the hell do you think you people are? You are very, very dangerous people indeed. Your obsession with creating this euro state means that you're happy to destroy democracy. You appear to be happy for millions and millions of people to be unemployed and to be poor. Untold millions must suffer so that your euro dream can continue. Well, it won't work, because it's Portugal next. With their debt levels of 325% of GDP, they're the next ones on the list, and after that, I suspect it'll be Spain. And the bailout for Spain would be 7 times the size of Ireland, and at that moment, all of the bailout money has gone. There won't be any more. But it's even more serious than economics. Because if you rob people of their identity, if you rob them of their democracy, then all they are left with is nationalism and violence. I can only hope and pray that the Euro project is destroyed by the markets before that really happens.